Hello everyone, I hope you had a great weekend. We have a new student named Vaibhavi Gude who has joined 3D on 3rd of July. Now she has a lot of work to complete, so many videos to watch and get her work done. So teacher thought of helping her to count and organize the work by grouping each video according to the subjects, and in this way her work will be more simple and she can complete it on time. Now by doing this, Vaibhavi has collected some data, and today I am going to teach you what is called data handling. What is data handling? Data is a collection of information, and handling means sorting information. Data handling helps to present data quickly and in an easy manner by grouping each object and counting the object in each group. In data handling, we first group each type of object and then count each object in a group. We can represent data in different ways. The objectives of data handling is to collect data, record data by using tally marks, represent data pictorially, and interpret data in using a chart or bar graphs. The concepts that we'll cover today are pictographs, tally marks, bar graphs, and map reading. What are pictographs? A pictograph is a representation of data using images. Here we have an example of a pictograph. The title here is number of students and fruits. There are four different type of fruits, and each fruit is equal to two students. In the mangoes, we have three mangoes. That means six students like mangoes. In the next picture, we have apples. There are 10 apples, but we know that each apple is equal to 2 students. So there are 20 students who love apples. We got bananas, and there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 bananas. But each banana is equal to 2 students. That means 8 into 2 gives us 16, and 16 children love bananas. So instead of drawing 16 times bananas, that makes our work easy, and so we get to count easily. Oranges, there are about 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 oranges. But we also know that each orange is equal to 2. So 10 children love oranges. We take another example. Here, the title of this example is favorite vegetables. Each vegetable, one vegetable is equal to one student. The vegetables are tomato, capsicum, carrot, mushroom, and potato. Now, here we have four tomatoes. So the number of students who love tomatoes are 4, because here one vegetable is equal to one student. In our previous example, we had the apple or the fruit equal to 2 students, but we don't have it here. We have one vegetable equal to one student. So counting becomes very easy when you look at the pictograph. Look at the capsicums are 3, so 3 students' favorite fruit vegetable is capsicum. The carrots are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. When we count, just look and count, we know that 6 students love carrot. Similarly, we have the mushrooms. How many mushrooms are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 children love mushroom. Now you will help teacher count the potatoes. How many potatoes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That means we have 4 tomatoes, 3 capsicum, 6 carrots, 5 mushrooms, and 7 potatoes. Isn't it fun doing pictographs? Let's take another example. In this example, you also have fruits, but the key, the smileys represent one vote. So here we have fruits like the apples, the pear, the grapes, the banana. So one smiley, one vote is equal to one smiley. That means the student, one vote, we need to count how many votes are here. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 smileys. That means the favorite fruit of the students is the apple. Now, in the next picture, we have the pear. Let's count how many smileys are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 smileys. So 7 children love pear. For the grapes, we have just 2. That means very few students, only 2 students love grapes. While the bananas are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 smileys, which denote 6 students love banana. So in this way, you can do your pictograph by putting them in columns like this. Look at the number of smileys that are given, because each smiley represent one vote. So students have voted, and that tells you that that many students love that particular fruit. Here we have another pictograph where you can see different animals. I give you some time, look at the picture, find out which are the different type of animals. All right, the different animals that we can see here are, in a bowl you can see the fish, there are dogs, there are cat, and there are birds. Now, how many pets are there in total? Now we need to find out how many pets are there in total, because they are pets. So let's count how many pets are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. We have got 20 in all. We have 20 animals in our whole picture. Which pets are more in number, birds or fish? So let's see. You can, in the picture, without counting, you can have a look and you know that the birds are the most, isn't it? Here, so the fish is less than the birds. List the pets in order from fewer to more. So let's find out how many pets we have in all. So we have 20 in total. Which pets are more in number, birds or fish? Birds. And the pet, list the pets in order from fewer to more. It is the kittens that are here. Then we have the dogs, then we have the fish, and last we have the birds. Did you find this interesting? Looking at pictures and counting the difference between the animals. Second concept is tally marks. What are tally marks? Tally marks are a quick way of keeping track of numbers in groups of five. This method helps to count large numbers in a very simple and quick way. For every count, we make one vertical line, and the fifth line we cut a diagonal through the four. So we get a section of five lines. So this makes counting very easy. This is how we write tally marks. If you see, we have four vertical lines with one line cutting diagonally. When we look at the picture, we see so many lines, but it is easy to count because each section is of five. So if we have five here, we will know, it will be easy for us to count and find out how many it's in total. So 5 plus 5 makes 10, and 10 plus 5 makes 15. 15 plus 5 is 20. 20 plus 5 is 25. 25 plus 5 is 30. 30 plus 5 is equal to 35. 35 plus 5 becomes 40. 40 plus 5 becomes 45. 45 plus 5 is 50. 50 plus 5 is 55, and 55 plus 5 is 60. We have counted so many lines in 2 seconds. So isn't it very easy to count by tally marks? Let's do an example. Here in tally marks, I told you, you have to write the numbers that are written here are 1 to 10. So for a circle which is here, which has one dot, has one number, so we have to put one stroke. For two, we have to put two vertical lines. For three, we put three vertical lines. For four, we put four. For five, we use the fifth one as a diagonal. We cut the five for it to make a section of five, and it is easy to count. Now we have six. So what do we do now? So for the sixth one, we write a single vertical line. Because we have five, we have put it in a section, and then we write one. Similarly, for the number seven, we write four strokes, cut it diagonally, and write two separate strokes, which makes seven. Next is eight. Eight, we also write in the similar manner, write four vertically with one diagonal stroke, and then we have the three strokes which makes number eight. The nine is also followed in the similar manner. You write 1, 1, 1, 1, and then a diagonal stroke. And then we have the four stroke. Can we make another diagonal? No. Because if we do so, then we get 10. But we can do that for the number 10. Here, we put four strokes, and diagonally, we make it one section. So 1 plus 1 of 5 each gives us 10. Let's do another example with pictures. We have another example of tally marks. Here, we have favorite pets. And the pets are a cat, a dog, and a guinea pig. Now let's find out, the cat is the most loved pet. So we have the number that the children love is 10. So we have put tally marks in four strips, vertical lines, and one diagonal. We have cut it diagonally. It doesn't matter whether you cut it this way or this way, but you require to make one diagonal line. So it is very easy, 1, 2, and that makes 10. The dog, there is only 4, so we had to write only 4 strokes. In the next guinea pig, we have 6. So we have made 4 vertical lines, cutting it and making a section of 5, and we get 1. So 5 plus 1 gives us 6. Let's solve together. Here in this tally marks, we have some objects. Here there are 6 toys. Then we have balls, Christmas trees, cakes, looks like chocolate cakes with nice blue candles. We have the rugby ball. Now here, these toys are 6 in number. So we have done 4 tally vertical marks with 1 diagonal, grouping it in a section of 5. So 5 plus 1, we get 6. Now we have only 4 balls, and so we don't need to make the diagonal because there are only 4 balls. So we can make only 4 vertical lines. In our next, we have 2 Christmas trees. So we make 2 vertical lines to denote number 2. We have 3 cakes. So we make 3 vertical lines for the 3 cakes. And we have only 1 rugby ball, and so we make only 1 straw. Let's try doing an example using straws. Here I have an apple tree. Let's count how many apples are there on the tree. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Using the straws, let's put the tally marks. Now for 1 apple, I put 1 tally mark. For the 2nd apple, I take another one. For the 3rd one, I use another straw. And for the 4th one, I use another one. So I have 4 vertical lines with 4 yellow straws. Now for my 5th apple, I am going to put a diagonal to make the group or a section of 5. So I have 4 vertical lines cutting with a diagonal. Now I have counted 5. Now let's count the remaining. 1, so I put 1 here for this, that is the 6th. Here I have the 7th one, the 8th one, the 9th, and for the 10th, we make another set of 5. Now we have 2 left. So we will use 1 straw and another one to make tally marks of 12 apples that we have on the tree. Now I hope you have understood how to do tally marks. Our next topic is bar graphs. Look at the pictures. We are using tally marks here, and we have tallied the fruits. What are bar graphs? A graphical representation of data, quantities or numbers using bars or strips. A bar graph are used to compare and contrast numbers, frequencies and other measurements. It's very simple and easy to form the graph. On a paper, we can draw 2 lines, one vertical and one horizontal line, and then make bars of using different shades of color. Here we have an orange, 5 orange. So what we're going to do is we're going to color 5 columns so that we can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But you have to be careful when you do one particular fruit or one object, it has to be of one color only. So we go to our next picture, and the next picture is the apple, and we see 2 tally marks. So then we have to color only 2 groups or two blocks. So here we will color two blocks which are blue in color. In the next picture we have bananas which are six in number. Here we have put a tally mark for the five and one is separate, one vertical stroke. So what we are going to do, take a green color and color the blocks six times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, because we are making a graph. Next fruit, we have kiwis. How many vertical lines are there? Three. That means we have three kiwis. So what we're going to do is take a pink color and shade it three times, three blocks, 1, 2, and 3. Isn't it easy? Let's take another example. Here, the students survey their favorite fruits. We have also done this in tally marks. Now the bar graphs that are done here is on the vertical line, we have the picture of the different fruits. On the horizontal line, we have mangoes, apples, grapes, bananas, orange written. Now these are called the axes. So when we are doing a bar, when we draw the bar graph, it's very important to have the vertical and horizontal line on an axis. Say this, we're writing the numbers this side and where we have written the fruits, the names of the fruits. And we are going to color using different colors to show how many fruits are there. Students survey their favorite fruits. We have to draw the bar graph, we need to draw a vertical line and a horizontal line. The axis is very important. So we have fruits like the orange, the banana, the grapes, the apple and the mango. And on this side we have the fruits, the names written of the fruits that are orange, banana, grapes, apples and mangoes. When we survey, we will come to know, because each block is equal to 20 students. One block is equal to 20 students. Now let's take the mangoes. We find the students who are found of mangoes is only 20, because only from 0 to 20, only one block has been colored. And each block, we have to tally it with the numbers written on the vertical line. So here in the second, we have apples. Now apples, the number of students that love apples is 60. Why? Because the number that is tallying to it is 60. So we know now that 60 students love apples. In the next one, which is a block of green, we have grapes. Let's see what is the number that tallies with grapes, the green color block. We find that it is 80. That tells us that 80 students love grapes. In our next picture, which is orange, are the bananas. Let's find out how many students love bananas. And here we find that 100 students love bananas. Why is teacher saying 100? Because the graph tells us it is tallying with 100 students. Can you see? Now we come to orange. And what do we notice with the orange? We find that when we are tallying it, we are in midway. We are here. That means one block is equal to 20. So to this block, which has already reached 40. So 40 to 60, we have 20 in between. And now the oranges, the students that like oranges is 50. So the least number. When we look at the picture, we can compare. We can compare. I told you that you can compare and contrast. Here we find the students who love bananas is the maximum, is the most of the students like bananas. It's almost 100%. The least loved fruit is the mango. Is there any fruit that the students, two fruits of the similar number? No. It goes increasing. Which is the second fruit that is loved the most? Are the grapes. And the least loved fruit are the mangoes. Same graph we have done here. Here we have done with columns. The mangoes, the apples, the grapes, the bananas and oranges are written vertically, and horizontally we have the numbers written to show how the children love. It is actually the same bar graph, but here we have written the order from 0 to 10 to 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. This makes, when you are doing a graph like this, is telling you that each block is 10, but here each block is equal to 20. Just to simplify how we get the 50, teacher has given you another example. I hope you are following what exactly is happening. The survey with the fruits is very interesting once you get the hang of what is to be done. Let's go and see the animals on Old MacDonald's farm. Here there are number of animals. The number is written on a vertical line, and on the horizontal line we have the names of the animals written, or the type of animals. So in the first slot we have the horses. Let's find out, looking at the bar graph, what type of an animal is here. They are the horses. How many? Let's find out. How many horses? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have 4 horses. How many cows do we have? We have 2. So we have a bar graph for 2. The roosters are 3 in number. So we have to count. So we have 3 roosters. Sheep, we have only 1. And so on the x-axis, you see here, we have y-axis and x-axis. I told you it's very important. The vertical line is the y and the horizontal line is the x-axis. So we found out how many animals are there on the animal farm at Old MacDonald's farm. Let us learn something about maps. What is map reading? A map is a drawing of all or a part of the earth's surface. Its basic purpose is to show where things are. Maps may show visible features such as rivers, lakes, forests, buildings, and even roads. They may also show things that cannot be seen, such as boundaries and temperatures. Here you can see a compass rose, which we usually say compass, which is used to locate a place. You also must have seen in your cars the GPS, which helps us to know directions. The compass always points to the north. So to the right of you is always, the location is the east, and to your left is the west. The above your head is the north and below is the south. These are called 4 main cardinal directions. What teacher has shown you is a compass rose. These are used by people like the pilots, the captains, and even when you need to know or to locate a direction, you can use the compass. Now that we know the directions, let us learn about map reading. How to read a map? A map always has a key. The key tells us what the things are there on the map. What is the map about? And it has a title. The title of our map is Our Little Town Map. In the map, before you read, you have to see what is given to you. You have here a lake, little town. You have the hospital. The key tells you what these pictures are for. For example, here it's not written a hospital, but the key tells us that this denotes the hospital. The next picture is the library. In our key also tells us that this is the library. Here we have the little town park, the lake, little town. Can you see the lake? Yes. So we have trees and we have houses. We have the road. You can see the road. You can see a post office. There's so many things that tell us. And we also have our four cardinal points. What are they? They are the north, south, east, and west. So north, south, east, west. I will ask you some questions. You have a look at the map and hopefully you'll be able to answer the questions that follow. Here, the first question is, what is the title of this map? Do you remember? I will show you the map again. What is the title of the map? Can anyone answer? Yes, the title is Our Little Town Map. The next question, from the post office, is the lake to the north or the south? Without going to the picture of the map, can anyone answer? All right, you need to look at the map. Here we go. What the question is, from the post office, is the lake north or south? Let's find out, is the lake north or south? The lake is to your north, because it is asked, is the lake north to the post office? In what direction? Is it north or south to the post office? So suppose this is north, so the lake belong is in the north direction. And here is your post office. So the answer to that question, from the post office, is the lake north or south? The answer is north. If you are at the library, which direction will you take to go to the town neighborhood? They are asking you that if you are at the library, which direction will you go or will you take to go to the town neighborhood? Let's find out. So the little town neighborhood is here and you are at the library. You are going to go to which direction? You are going to go to the south because you're coming down. So you are going to south. Let's go to the fourth question. What is to the west to the little town neighborhood? Now we have to find out what is to the west of the little town neighborhood. When we look at the map, we find the little town neighborhood is here. And to the west of the little town neighborhood is the lake, little town. We've get it. To the west is the lake Little Town. So the answer to the fourth question is to the west of the Little Town neighborhood is the lake Little Town. The last question is, what is to the east of the hospital? Now we have to find out where is the hospital. So we go back to the hospital. And the question is, what do you see to the east of the hospital? And to the east of the hospital is a little town park. To the east of the hospital is the little town park. So here, I hope you have followed how to do map reading and using the keys that are given, and also using your four cardinal location, the four cardinal points, north, south, east, west. It helps you to locate a place on a map. Here, teacher has drawn a map for map reading. I have a post office, I have a school, I have Aryan's house, I have a park here, and I have the express railways. So there are many things on the map. Now what I want you to do is make a key and form three questions on the map, so that in our next class you can ask teacher the questions and teacher will answer it for you. I hope you had fun doing map reading along with teacher. But please keep in mind that the four cardinal points is very important when you are doing math reading. So thank you. I hope you had fun.